Hello and welcome to what will be quite an exciting edition of LiveG Showcase. In this video, we'll be announcing the latest downloadable alpha release of our desktop and mobile operating system, LiveG OS, to a variety of new platforms. This particular release has been in the works for quite some time now. It's been nearly a year since our last episode of LiveG Showcase, where we released our first alpha version of LiveG OS, and over 8 months since our last video here on YouTube. But for those who are not yet familiar with LiveG OS, here's a little trailer of all the things that LiveG OS can do so far. To some of the key highlights of this new alpha version of LiveG OS that we are releasing today. First up, of course, is that we are releasing LiveG OS to three new platforms. These are the PinePhone, the Raspberry Pi, and ARM64 computers, alongside our current support for x86-64. This new release therefore means that LiveG OS is one of the few operating systems that can be run on both desktop and mobile devices. We've also got a few new features that improve the mobile experience of LiveG OS that I'll be showing you later on. On the Raspberry Pi, LiveG OS runs on the Pi 4 as well as the Raspberry Pi Compute Module 4 and even the Raspberry Pi 3. Although it does run slightly slower and is a bit more power intensive on the older models such as the Pi 3. As for the PinePhone, it runs really well in fact on the PinePhone, but it's not available for the PinePhone Pro yet because we don't have a Pro model which is needed to build LiveG OS for it. But if you do have a PinePhone Pro, you can help us out and build LiveG OS for the Pro model by running our OS bootstrapper code on it, which is available from our GitHub. You can of course try out LiveG OS for your own devices now at liveg.tech/OS. It's actually really easy. You simply just have to download the disk image for your platform. Pop the disk image on an SD card using software such as Berliner Etcher or the Raspberry Pi Imager, and then boot up the OS on your device and follow the setup guide. And yeah, it should work well for you. And of course, on x86 and ARM computers, you can use the USB stick like you would do with other operating systems. Now on to another feature, which is support for progressive web apps, or PWAs as they are called. It's a really handy feature, which really makes LiveG OS that bit more daily drivable, which is really useful. And it allows you to run quite a lot of popular apps, such as Mastodon, Twitter, I mean X, YouTube, and also some of our own apps, such as LiveG Docs, onto the system. And yeah, this feature is quite important as there's a vast number of existing apps can already now run on LiveG OS that haven't been made specifically LiveG OS before, but will now run just fine. And therefore, in turn, this will help us to basically compete with existing operating systems, so it's quite exciting. Related to PWAs is some of the improvements for the app menu. The app menu now lists all your installed apps, and so you can now switch between the grid and alphabetical views, which display the apps in different configurations. The alphabetical view is necessary because we do have some future plans to allow you to drag and drop all the apps in the grid view. So it'd be nice to have alphabetical sorting for when you want to search an app by name, for example. Talking of searching apps, you can actually type in apps to search by name. For example, we can type in settings, or you can actually type in app shortcuts. So for apps which do support shortcuts, you can enter a shortcut name such as network, and it will come up right there, which is really easy. Also in the app menu are power options, and also you can bring up the power menu on mobile by holding down the power button, of course. Sphere has also now gotten a tabbed interface, which makes it much easier to browse the web inside Sphere without having to open too many windows. And this makes Sphere behave much more like your typical modern web browsers that we have today. Links can also open up in new tabs if you middle-click links, but also links which are designed to open in new tabs will work in Sphere now. And we also do have some future plans to implement some APIs so that any web app can have their own tab interfaces, and we hope to use this in the upcoming file manager app that we hope to develop soon. Moving on mobile, there is now a new system for navigating the app switcher using gestures. So for example, you can swipe up from the LiveG logo to reveal a list of apps, which is really, really quite handy. And you can also directly switch between apps without having to swipe up and go into the switcher by swiping horizontally at the bottom there, which is much quicker than having to double tap to view your apps. And of course the double tapping will still work for those who don't really like swiping, but the swiping method is there if you want to kind of build up your muscle memory. And now on to quite a big addition to LiveG OS, which is the update system. You can now update LiveG OS from settings, from the settings app. And new releases will now be available through the this update system for subsequent alpha releases. You can also choose an update circuit in the advanced options menu of the settings app, and that allows you to choose whether you want to receive alpha or beta builds or the official releases of LiveG OS, depending on if you want cutting edge additions or not. And also the update system is designed to not be too distracting. The system won't impose updates on you, so when you're shutting down the system, unlike certain popular operating systems such as, well, say Microsoft Windows, you don't have to update your system before restarting or shutting down, which has previously been quite a gripe from users of Windows, so we don't have that on LiveG OS. And of course you can choose when to restart the system. You can either restart the system manually, or you can choose to automatically restart the system once the update's been applied, which is really useful for unattended updates. The update system is also really robust against things such as power outages, or as we like to call them, unscheduled system shutdowns. So LiveG OS will try to recover the system state to the previous version using a few mechanisms if something goes wrong along the way. Continuing on with the settings app, there have been a number of additional options which have been added to the app. To start with, you can now configure Wi-Fi networks, including authentication options such as WEP, WPA, WPA2, and also the enterprise versions, otherwise known as 802.1x. So you can now specify Wi-Fi passwords when connecting to a Wi-Fi network, or in the case of the enterprise versions, you know, your username and your password, and those kind of details. You can also configure keyboard layouts in settings. This is really useful as LiveG OS can currently be used at all in the French language. So now being able to change to the French AZERTY keyboard layout is quite useful. And also US QWERTY can be added as an option to your keyboard layout list. And this is on top of the current support for British QWERTY, which is the default. And there's also Chinese pinyin entry, so you can enter Chinese pinyin text and it will come out as Chinese characters. And that's using the input method editor, which uses basically the same mechanism as text suggestions system for the mobile keyboard. And also on mobile, these keyboard layouts are also available as virtual keyboard layouts that you can choose in settings as well. Moving on to another thing that's been added to the settings app, which are the interaction and privacy options. So you can now turn on and off options for when you'd like LiveG OS to connect to our website for our online services. So for example, with our update system, you can now choose whether you want the update system to automatically check for updates, or if you just want it to manually check for updates when you enter the settings app. There's also telemetry options, but this is turned off by default. Telemetry in LiveG OS is actually used just for research purposes. We're not in the business of selling your data or using your data for targeted advertisements. That'd be against our values, really. But yeah, telemetry data is used for research purposes, and we hope to publish the data openly while preserving user anonymity. But in any case, you can turn all these interaction and privacy options completely off if you want, an air-gapped instance of LiveG OS. And also, moving on to the improvements to the out-of-box setup system, or the OOPS as we like to call it. We've added a power menu and an accessibility menu to the OOPS, which make it much easier to configure those options while you're setting up your device. So you can now shut down the system before you finish setting it up. And you can also configure accessibility options before you finish setting up your device. And there's also a new setup step for configuring the aforementioned interaction and privacy options, as well as animated graphics, which make the setup process much more interesting and visually appealing. So that's a rundown of the new features that have been included in LiveG OS. No wonder it's been a while since our last release. There's still lots to be done for LiveG OS before it becomes daily drivable though. Our main focus for developing the next update will be to build some new system apps, such as a calculator, a file manager, apps with cellular features such as SMS texting and phone calling, and a few other useful tools that brings LiveG OS in line with other systems functionality wise. It's also worth noting some of our side projects that we've been working on for LiveG OS, and we're excited to be fully integrating them into the system soon. TypeSet Engine is our syntax highlighted code editor, which we hope to integrate into an IDE. It's already deployed on LiveG Docs to make our code snippets a bit easier to read. LiveG Search is our search engine that is already presented to LiveG OS users when they open new Sphere tabs. We're hoping to launch a much better crawling and indexing system for that soon. And finally, Formulaic is our expression evaluation engine that can crunch complex mathematical expressions. And we hope to implement that into the upcoming system calculator app soon to make it perhaps the most advanced system calculator app seen on any other operating system yet. And it's a bit early to say this just now, but we're thinking about also integrating Linux apps into LiveG OS, so you can easily use your favourite Linux applications right in G-shell, much like you can do on Chrome OS. I'll definitely daily drive LiveG OS once Linux app integration is added. It's definitely going to be a useful feature, especially as a developer who makes the use of a lot of Linux applications and command line tools already. It's something that we won't see in the next release, but it's certainly on our radar, and you might see Linux app integration in LiveG OS perhaps in a few releases time. And finally, a quick peek at another little project that we've been working on recently, and that is LiveG OS Nano, a more compact edition of LiveG OS that is designed to be run on microcontrollers and low power devices. The plan is to build a smartwatch called the LiveG Duration and have it run apps written in JavaScript and a version of LiveG's Astronaut, which would make it a nice addition to the LiveG ecosystem. So that's it for this episode of LiveG Showcase. I'm sure that you're excited to try out LiveG OS for yourself, and you can of course do so at liveg.tech/OS. If you'd like to support us, you can do so financially via Open Collective at opencollective.com/liveg, and your donations will go towards developing our exciting LiveG software and hardware projects. You can also support us by joining our Discord community, where we collaborate with making our projects. You can also find links to our GitHub organisation, Mastodon, and X profiles, and more on our website at liveg.tech. Until then, on behalf of all the team here at LiveG, we'd like to thank you for watching, and we'll see you, hopefully somewhat sooner this time, in the next episode of LiveG Showcase. Goodbye.